When we got engaged, it wasn't like a let's figure out if we like being engaged. We knew we wanted to be together forever, so a wedding was just kind of the ceremony to officiate it. But so whether, you know, we got engaged and got married the next day, we were okay with that. So we were just kind of like, all right, well, let's go to Mexico and check it out and plan a wedding. We decided to go to Puebla, and it was a beautiful historic city that we thought maybe we could host the wedding there.
Puebla is about 3 hours away from Mexico City.
We were going with the intention of finding a wedding planner, finding a venue to kind of settle everything so that when we left, it would all be planned.
And we were about an hour into the trip, and we get hit from behind. Someone walks up to Jen's passenger window. And I remember telling Jen, don't open the window, just crack it open so that we could hear what they had to say. A kid, maybe 22, 25 years old, clean cut, shaven, walks up smiling, talking to Jen in Spanish, obviously.
And he was like super apologetic, and he's just like, I'm so sorry.
I just hit you in the back. You may want to look at it, or, you know, but I don't think anything happened.
Yeah, let's go take a look, all right?
I told Jen, I'm gonna go out, lock the door when I leave. I walk around from the driver's side.
Yeah, it doesn't look so bad.
As I'm bending down, I hear the door open. As that moment was happening, and I thought, we're in trouble now. First thought was, Jen's in the car. What's gonna happen to Jen?
And then they push Frank in the car with a gun to his head.
They quickly hooded me, so I didn't really see what was going on.
Si te mueves, te voy a matar.
They're speaking to us in Spanish the whole time. If you move, I'm gonna kill you, and we're gonna kill her. I was trying not to think of the worst case scenario, but they were doing it as part of the eventual ransom. We knew that they didn't speak English. And so we were conversing with them in Spanish the whole time. When we wanted to speak to each other, we would speak in English. And I tell Jen, we have to do something. We have to try to run away.
Abrácense los dos. Vamos, abrácense.
Vamos, rápido, rápido. Abrácense los dos.
And they told us to hug each other. And at that point, I thought they were gonna kill us.
One of the guys took me away from Frank, and he made me sit on the ground. I prayed. And I just said, God, I need a miracle right now. And at that second, the guy put his gun down, and I grabbed his gun. He jumps on my back. The only thing I'm focused on at that point is I'm trying to get my finger in the trigger. And I'm also thinking, whatever happens, this barrel cannot face you. I've never shot a gun in my life, but my hands are too small to reach inside of the trigger, and I didn't want to let go of the grip that I had.
I heard some commotion in the background. And I said to myself at that second, I had planted the seed in Jen's head of trying to run. And I thought that she was starting to run. So I thought I would start running and we would cause confusion between them and cause them to run after, you know, both of us or one of us, and I thought we could both outrun them.
And then the guy that was watching Frank comes back and says,
Safeway, Safeway.
He's gone. And the other guy lets go of the chokehold. The bigger guy, who was probably like 6 foot something, just punched me straight in the face and broke my nose. And then once he punched me in the face and broke my nose, they tied my hands behind my back and they tied my feet. And then they went to look for Frank.
I'm just running on adrenaline. I'm praying, I hope Jen is running. And I go to a gas station and there were two workers inside.
Move over, please. Please call the police. The police here. They kidnapped us. They still have her. They still have her. Please. 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 Please.
A police car comes 5 minutes later.
Oh, please. Please help. They kidnapped us. They still have her. Please.
Frank!
I heard Frank's voice. And then we started calling to each other. Although I knew that he would never bring danger to me, I didn't know if they had captured him with a gun to his head.
Frank?
Jen!
I couldn't believe it. I mean, I heard her voice. And then, you know, everything else was a miracle.
To see him and knowing that he tried so hard to come back to me. He's my hero. He is. The officers drove us to the emergency room. I don't remember much from the emergency room because I was in shock. That was in May. I got surgery in June. They had to fix my nose, so I got nose surgery. And our wedding was in November. We decided to do it here in Miami.